Aries, it's me, Stormy, and here's your horoscope for May 2018. And what a beautiful month I think it's going to be. We've got a new moon that's going to be having some aspects, some beautiful workings between Jupiter and Neptune. So this just brings a lot of optimism, generosity. There's a lot of Venus energy floating around this month with a lot of planetary movement moving into Taurus. So this is brilliant for value. This is also going to light up plenty of space for you in your second house of not only finances, okay, but also of value and esteem. And man, you just came out of birthday time, Aries. You got to have some new self-esteem. This self-esteem, this value, this you has got to be a little bit more on fleek. Not to mention, Uranus is going to move out of Aries for a time into the sign of Taurus. So again, shaking up the space of value, but moving out of your sign, it's going to give you a little bit of perspective on the shakeup that it gave you about your identity, your image, your life. All of these changes that Uranus brought in, I think you really get to see the value and start placing a value on them this month. Not to mention with all of this Taurus energy and then moving towards the end of the month into Gemini energy, it is a wonderful month to be social. So it's going to be a really good time. But let's jump in here and let's talk about some of these dates because I want to get you into May and then out so you're living your life, okay? At the beginning of the month here on the 3rd, this is a great day to make note of because Mercury officially leaves its shadow zone. So what that means is that Mercury is unpacking the bags. We've got full direct motion. Mercury's on fleek, got the good orbit. We've got the blessings. They are upon us, which is gorgeous because on the 13th, Mercury is actually going to move over into Taurus, lighting up conversation, busyness, decision-making, communications in your second house. So this could also look like maybe you're being a little bit more busy, right? Maybe you've decided to pick up some more shifts because at the beginning of the month, we've got Mars and Pluto kind of conjunct at the top of your chart in your 10th house. So by the time we get mid-month, you could definitely be a lot more busy at work, doing things. Even if it's not work, it could be that soul level calling and you're just a lot more busy bringing value. Your self-esteem is different and you're bringing that to the table. Now, speaking of Mars, Mars on the 12th of this month is going to move into its pre-retrograde status. So remember, as planets are getting ready to take their retrograde, there's a phase they got to go through. First, they got to pack all of their bags, and that's what Mars is going to start doing on the 12th. So you may start to see your actions. You're trying to push some actions forward. I mean, your ruling planet is packing. He's getting ready to go on a trip, so he's not really paying attention to you. You know what I mean? He's like, yeah, I got it. You want to do stuff. Okay, but I'm packing. Okay, so keep that in mind. And then he's going to move into the retrograde, out of the retrograde, and then he needs to unpack. But we're going to do the packing during this month. Okay, so just be mindful of that. You may need to pay a little bit more attention to your actions, and you may need to take more purposeful actions, right? Like Aries, you are very good at impulsive, direct actions, energies. You may need to speak with more purpose. You may need to act with more purpose this month. That is definitely something to consider. Now on the 15th of the month, we have got the new moon coming here into Taurus, along with we've got Venus over here in Gemini. And just behind this, we've got Uranus moving out of your sign and into Taurus. So let's talk about this. Now this new moon's gonna be at 24 degrees of Taurus, lighting up the second house. Remember, at the new moon, we plant these seeds of intention. What is this new beginning you want? What do you want your esteem to look like? What do you value? What is the value of things that you have, your material value? Do you value the things that you have, or is it time to do a clean out, right? You want a fresh start? Do you value your relationships? For some of you at this new moon, if you have a Taurus in your life, you could find that they are lit up and you're valuing them differently in some way, shape, or form. Along with that, though, we do have Venus, this harmony energy over here in Gemini in the third house. So I mean, like the thought process behind this new beginning for you is harmonized, it's sensual, it's beautiful, it's diplomatic. There's value laid all over this new moon. So the question is, what do you value and how do you value what you have? Excuse me. Then Uranus moving over here into Taurus as well, again lighting up the second house. And I'm telling you, when Uranus comes, he comes to break down the structures that we've had before, right? So he wants something new here. He wants something innovative, intuitive, new for you, good for all, right? So you could be relooking at your finances in some way. And I'm telling you, this could also be maybe you're leaning into a talent you hadn't really been leaning into yet. So this is a wonderful time to take that evaluation on the road as well. Now on the 16th, we've got Mars making this movement into the sign of Aquarius. This is phenomenal because it's going to light up your social zone. The 11th house is friends, group associations, things where maybe you're in a position of leadership over a group, social things, right? Social networking also falls in here. And what I think is really important here, Aries, especially since we had Mars at the top of the chart for so long this month, is those long-range plans, goals, dreams, desires. What do you want? Mars is right here saying, let's take some action. At the beginning of the month, when Mars was at the top of your chart, Pluto was already retrograde, so you've been getting some behaviors out of the way so that you can have the life that you want. You've been getting some debt out of the way so that you can have the life that you want. Let's see how you want to show up here. As well, Mars in Aquarius could also be just attracting friends to you. And because Mars is in this pre-retrograde pack in his stuff zone, the shadow time, you could also have old friends come back into your life. And you see if those associations fit and work out now. Really exciting. So leadership opportunities, friendship opportunities are certainly here. And for some of you, I'm getting that you may launch a social project or something like that. So that'll be very exciting. Now on the 19th, we have Venus move on over here into the sign of Cancer. How delicious. Venus in Cancer, this is like, it's like nurturing meets sensuality meets just, it's a big delicious hug, you know what I mean? So this is a great energy for harmony at home, fourth house, home, family, real estate, property, your internal values, relationships with women, your relationships with yourself, beautifying your home. Venus loves to come over into Cancer because she's like, oh, I love you so much. Let's make this wall pink. You know what I mean? So you could be beautifying, but whatever it is, this is a lot of Venetian energy coming to bring harmony to this fourth house space for you. Beautiful. Now on the 20th, we see the sun shift into Gemini. So this lights up your third house, communication, networking. You could get busy. Those text messages could be on go. You could be talking to a lot of people. You maybe have new friends in. I mean, the sun's out, at least here in the United States. You could be out riding your motorcycle. You could be whatever it is. You're getting very social and you're needing to make decisions. But one of the beautiful things I think about the renewal of this sun at this time is that you could also notice that your thinking around things is much different and much clearer at this time. So this is a wonderful energy with the sun here. If you need to sign contracts, if you're ready to launch that website, if you need to make a decision about something, this is beautiful. As well, you have all that harmonizing energy of Venus saying, what's the value of this before you're even jumping off into this energy. So really good time if you need to make some decisions. Of course, that will depend on your individual natal charts. Now on the 25th, we've got Jupiter in a trine to Neptune. I love this energy for us. This is optimistic. This is generous. This is compassion. These two are, they see each other. They acknowledge each other. They want to help each other out here. This is going to lie between the 8th house where Jupiter is at for you and the 12th house where Neptune is at. So in this is intimacy. This is intimacy. This is beautiful, spiritual, expanding intimacy. You could be expanding. You could be shedding some fears here. You're letting some things go. You're like, ooh, brush my shoulders off. It's summertime. We're getting towards summertime. You know, there's just a level of spiritual intimacy here, especially with Chiron now in Aries. I think you are really seeing some things where you have an opportunity to just grow, to be fab, to expand, to allow yourself to be more vulnerable, to allow yourself to come into different kind of partnerships that are beautiful, beautiful for you. For some of you, again, Aries, I keep getting this idea of debt. Some of you will clean out debt, and that is intimate cleaning out for sure. Now on the 29th, we've got the full moon happening at 9 degrees of Sagittarius. So beautiful, beautiful, expansive energy, right? Like you're getting out there. The full moon says we need to end something, acknowledge something, adjust something, right? We're going to have to hit a swap or a switch here. So for some of you, you could be finishing educational certificate programs. You could be graduating. This could be a wonderful graduation time. Some of you are having this more expanded faith. And I do think that for many of you, because you've had this Mars energy in the 11th house, lighting up that dream and that plan kind of place. Some of you will be planning some travel because we've also got Mercury and Gemini in the third house at this time. These are our travel energies. So you could be like, I'm planning a trip. I want to go on a trip. I want to launch an online course. I want to study something online, right? Because Taurus is the ruler of the month, really, truly. And Taurus does like to be at home and be cozy. So this could definitely be an energy where you're doing some kind of learning in a more expanded way, but you're doing it close to home. So I think it's going to be a beautiful month. I look forward to seeing any and everything you get yourself into. Remember, those Chiron and Aries videos are still available. There is a limited number of them. If you want more details, click in the description box down below. As well, you can join me for $3 Thursdays this May, and we are going to be talking about Chiron, transiting Chiron in Aries. We're going to talk about it through the houses. So I look forward to seeing you however we're going to connect this month. I'm sending you a massive amount of love, okay, Aries? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I will see you next week, okay? Oh, next month, okay? Bye, guys.